And now you are later in life. You're not a young 20, 30 year old. You're in your 40s, 50s, 60s. The big challenge there is finding a man to share that with. And the challenge is to find that happiness within. And all of that in my most recent work, Beyond Mars and Venus, is understanding men from Mars is understanding good communication skills and how men and women misunderstand each other, how we can understand each other better. But to go beyond that is to understand that we are hormonal beings and that our hormones determine our feelings in the instinctive brain of who we're attracted to and how we feel in the presence of another person. And when a woman is, you know, in her 40s, 50s, 60s, she's way more independent. She's way more confident. She's less dependent on others. And it turns out that what makes women attractive to men and what makes women attracted to what makes men attracted to women and women attracted to men is a hormonal difference. When a woman's estrogen levels, female hormone, is much, much higher than a man's, men are attracted to you. And when a man's testosterone levels are much higher than yours, you're attracted to them. So there's this difference that the polarity has to be there of hormones. If somebody's just like you, there's no attraction. They're you, they're a friend, you have similar interests and so forth. But it's the hormonal differences that creates an interest, a passion that can take you from happiness to beyond happiness, to making you happier. And you make him happier than he can be alone. He can make you happier than you alone. But it takes a foundation to get to that step. And the foundation there is your own inner happiness, which is to understand as a woman, the challenges you have are enormous without some new clarity, some new insight. Because you, when you're financially secure based upon your own earning power, you're making male hormones. And when you're depending on somebody else, where you're having to practice appreciating, accepting, trusting, all those qualities produce estrogen. And estrogen has to actually double for you to have an orgasm. Normally, women's estrogen levels, you know, you look on the averages and the hormonal charts and so forth in medicine, women's estrogen of a happy, fulfilled woman is 10 times higher than a happy, fulfilled man. So that's our baseline. But then when you're in a romantic relationship and you have sex, your estrogen levels will double if you have orgasm. So you have to be able to feel within yourself this feminine quality of depending. And I know for many women, oh, I'm not going to depend on anybody. That makes me weak. That makes me, it's the opposite of independent. But actually, it's freedom. Because both men and women have a male and a female side. We all have estrogen. We all have testosterone. Testosterone says, I can do it myself. Estrogen says, I need your help. I don't want to do it all myself. Why should I do it all myself? It's right. You know, sometimes I talk about male and female power. The male side of us, the power is, look what I can do all by myself. I don't need anybody. But the female power inside of us is, look what I can get other people to do for me. I don't have to do it all. Isn't that a wonderful thing to not have to do it all?
So it's a wonderful thing.
It's a wonderful thing. And women should know is that this is what I see with so many women, maybe all women when I'm in the counseling room, is asking them questions. Is there's this inner pressure. I have to do more. I'm not doing enough. I don't have enough time. I'm exhausted. I'm tired. I give, but I don't get back. I have to do it myself. Nobody can do it as good as me. All those. And when you look into the dating realm, typically speaking in the dating realm, the way it shows up is he's not good enough. You get overly picky when you're on your male side. You know, well, we got to fix that. Well, that's not there. Your mind goes into comparison, particularly as you get older, you have many other experiences. Well, he doesn't have this. He doesn't have that. Well, he's good at this, but not that. That we get lost in comparing when we're on our male side, because that's how do I solve the problem? I have to look at the options and solve the problem. I was at a seminar recently with some friends, and somebody quoted a beautiful quote, which is, comparison is the thief of happiness. Mm-hmm. That's what happens when your mind is looping and it's, what about this and what about this? Am I good enough? Is he good enough? When you're in a place of hormonal balance, you're in the moment. You're not having to compare with other situations to make this acceptable. You're right there present. And I know everybody talks about being present today, being in the moment today. And that is very important. But, you know, You can't be in the moment unless your hormones are in balance. So if we look at, if we come down to sort of a stratosphere of our physical body and our brain activity, it's dependent upon, are we doing behaviors and activities and attitudes and thinking that stimulates our female hormones, or are we doing what stimulates our male hormones? And when you find that you're unhappy as a woman, you're not going to be putting out the scent that makes men attracted to you or makes you attracted to them. There's a biological connection that happens simply being in the energy and the presence of someone. You will have a reaction. And by the way, the reaction you have when you're talking to somebody online, when you're meeting them online, is not necessarily going to last at all. It may, but it's all fantasy. It's the fantasy. It's not that you're actually in an energetic presence with somebody that your body will react to them hormonally. When you're on a screen, you're living in a fantasy world. You don't yet have the energetic connection.
Right.
So this we have to know in the dating situation, why often, and I say this is like really important for women, is at least when, if they're dating online and then they're going to meet in person, make sure that you have accurate pictures that you've shared before. I don't mean naked pictures. I just mean lots of pictures of you.
Right. So up-to-date pictures, right? Up-to-date, not from 10 years ago.
Yes. So important that the pictures are up-to-date. The reason for that is that once you meet the man, energetically, he may be attracted to you or not attracted to you. And energetically, it has nothing to do with your picture. See, it's, but you will feel as a woman, oh, my picture, you know, I gave fake pictures. Now he sees the real me. So the real me is not attractive. The truth is, a woman at any age can be attracted to a man and be attractive to a man if the energetics is there. And this is something women don't understand, because there's so much identification of women with body and youthfulness and, you know, wrinkles and weight, all that stuff. You look every day, you go to an airport, you see 50 women practically naked with these skinny bodies. And so you kind of go, everybody's looking at that and women are looking at that. And that's beautiful. Youth is beautiful, no doubt about it. But then you compare yourself to that and feel inadequate. And so there's this whole pressure on women that in order to be attracted to a man, you have to look a certain way. You don't.
Oh, you're so right, John. You're so right.
You just have to be authentic and feminine. Men are attracted to femininity. You have to be more feminine than the man, and then he will be attracted to you. There's a natural energetics there. And a kind of a funny story. I remember when I was writing my book, Beyond, that book was Mars, Venus in the Bedroom. And I was writing it, and I was on a trip, and I was thinking of, I went to a lingerie store to buy lingerie for my wife, and she wasn't there. So couldn't have sex. I'm thinking about sex. So I went into a lingerie store and I asked them, any funny stories you have about women shopping for lingerie? Cause I'll put it in my book. And they said, yeah, three women come into a lingerie store and they're all in their 60s. They're overweight. And two of them are buying what was called utility underwear, bras and panties.
Yeah.
The utility stuff.
And yeah, then, the granny panties and
granny
stuff.
Granny panties, right. And then one of them is not. She's got this whole sexual thing going on. You know, she's wearing something very sexual and everything. And the other women are like disgusted with her. That's their reaction, she says. They're like, "What? Who do you think you are? You know, what are you wearing that for? You don't look so hot, you know." And she said, You women do not understand men. When you're the only naked woman in the room, to that man, you're $1 million. And that's if women could just get that, you know. It's now, certainly, if you got a young, hot, you know, 25-year-old in a bathing suit, the guy's attention is going to go there. Why does it go there? I'll let you know. She's putting out more pheromones. It's a biological connection because she's got this young body and she knows everybody's interested in her. It stimulates her feelings of well-being, which produce those pheromones. It's all about the smell. And men, there's an extra nose up here that just, he's not conscious of it, but some women will just draw his attention. And doesn't mean that he's in love with them at all. It means that the primitive brain goes, oh, I can do her. As opposed to another woman who's not making those hormones to put out that scent, then you're not going to get the immediate reaction from men. But if you're in touch with your feminine energies, and your estrogen levels are in balance. They don't have to be as high as a young woman. They'll never be as high as, generally speaking, as high as a young woman. It's the balance of estrogen to testosterone. If your testosterone levels are lower and your estrogen is higher, then a man feels like, oh, I am needed by you, because estrogen is produced in your body when you feel I'm dependent on others for my well-being and not solely on myself. So you have a balance. Part of the day, you're depending on yourself. Part of the day, you're looking forward to somebody providing extra support for you. And so this is sort of a new picture of what we have to look for if we want to create, as a woman, to be attractive to a man and to be attracted to the man.